So traders, since I'm not going to continue trading today, let's take a look at my results here. Well, in fact, I'm having one of my best ever weeks, other than the Corona days, of course, because I've had plenty of days today over $20,000, $40,000, and another $22,000 day today. I'm probably somewhere in between $90,000 to $100,000. I'm not sure this week. So I'm really am having a perfect week. However, this day did not start so great. I was also down around $20,000 today, and let's go through what happened today a little bit so we understand what happened, what were my expectations, and again, what was my game plan. In order to talk about my game plan, you need to take a look at the S&P 500. So first, take a look at the S&P 500. We started down 2.3%. It was right over here. Now, we initially look at the first candle. We have a bottoming tail. We moved down. Then we moved up and started to move down again. That's the second candle and the third candle. We moved under the lows. Although the third looks green right now because we moved higher. But the game plan on a day like this, when the market's starting down that much, is what I mentioned when we started out today, is that there are going to be some kind of a push to the highs. Some people who are going to buy, find a good opportunity as they think to buy stocks which are low, some people who are bottom fishing, some people who are buying falling knives, which is usually the totally wrong idea of what you should be doing. You shouldn't be doing stuff like that. But some long-term investors are looking to do that. People are doing that. And that's why the market's starting down so much. You expect it to move higher. So I did not know if this second candle move up, these are 5-minute candles here in the S&P, was the one that's going to take the market down. I started shorting here. My first short was an amazing trade I've got today with Tesla. So Tesla worked out fine. But on the other hand, since the market started moving higher and I did not take my partials in Boeing and other, I had a losing trade in Boeing and so on. But again, I was waiting for the first market, the first move of the market. I was waiting for these buyers that I just described to get out of my way and for the market to do what it's supposed to do, which is a gap and go. Now, it did not happen during the first two or three candles, although I thought maybe it does. I was waiting for it to happen then. Some of the stocks that moved up with the market took me out. That's why I started down almost $20,000. But then, at the first sign of a pullback, right over here, we started shorting. Like, if you notice what I did back then, I shorted almost every stock that I thought which was relatively weak, like Boeing and Wynn and Facebook and what else is on my list here? UAL, which is just a very small winner. It just didn't work out fine. I also shorted NVX, which was wrong. I mean, NVX did come down, but that was relatively strong. I did short it because of the daily. I thought it's going to do better. Well, it's doing great right now. And of course, Facebook, which took me out because it moved over the highs, but then came down. Well, you got to have a stop somewhere. When a stock like Facebook, although I shorted it, moved over the highs, I had no choice. I had to move out. I could be wrong. I thought the market's going to come down under the lows, and it did come down under the lows. But I can't argue with the fact that Facebook's moving over the highs. When Facebook's moving over the highs, I just need to be out. And I did not reshort it again, although look at Facebook. It could have been my best trade, really. So anyway, I had plenty of shorts. I did add to Boeing as it was coming down because I thought Boeing had a very nice technical formation here at 186. So I did add. That's what turned Boeing to be such a very nice winner. I mean, you see Boeing now, I'm up like almost $9,000 in Boeing, but I was down like $6,000 or something like that earlier because I had my first losing day in Boeing, trade in Boeing. So my second trade actually covered my loss and much more than that. So altogether, I mean, end of the day for me, I was right about market direction and I was sticking to it. That was my game plan. My game plan was very clear. Look for the market to move higher. The first time I thought the market was moving higher, it was a failure because that didn't really work out. It came, sorry, the first time it moved higher, I started shorting. It came down. I was feeling like I was right, but then it came up again. The second time, well, that was the timing. I wish I would have called the second time only, but I did not. I couldn't have known that would be the first and then would come the second. I did expect the market to move higher with some pressure of buyers and fail, and that was exactly what happened. So I was sticking to my plan, and I'm glad I did that, because the end result is a beautiful green day. And I saw plenty of you guys who mentioned that they also moved from red to green territory, which makes me very, very happy. Because, you know, we were sticking to something we believed in, or I was sticking to something I was believing in. And if you followed me today, then you must have started in red, just like I did. But again, when the market starts with such a big gap, and we're seeing some signs of the market coming down, well, fine. Worked out after all. So I want to thank you very much for joining me today. I'm going to see some of you today on our Star Trader course, which starts at 3:15 today. And so thank you very much. Thank you very much to you on YouTube too. Appreciate that you're following us. And if you don't mind giving us a thumb up, I would like that very much. And Michael's here. So just enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you very much again. See you tomorrow or today at the Star Trader course. Thank you for watching our video. The material was taken from The Market Whisperer, my Amazon best-selling book. This essential guide to stock trading is ideal for those with no background or experience in stock trading. Click here to read the 200-page part one of this book absolutely free. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.